What's up, SaaS Masters? My name is George, and today I want to show you Pixelied. This one is an image editor. Now, there's a bunch of image editors out there, and the reason I'm making this video is to help you out to decide if you should get this or not, because you might have an alternative and it doesn't do what this one does, or maybe you have several others and this one doesn't do anything unique for you, so you don't need it, right? So we're gonna base that on this video. So I wanna show you what the deal is, and we're gonna jump over to the dashboard to show you how Pixelied works. So let's jump over to my dashboard and check it out. Okay guys, this is the deal that's going on right now, and it's $49 for a lifetime deal. I think it's not a bad deal. Like I said before, if you don't have an alternative, then this might be for you. So let's jump over to the plan and show you what that gets you. So the $49 gives you are the premium icons, upload your files, resize, custom fonts, and all of that good stuff. The code, $49, gets you the unlimited downloads, unlimited storage, unlimited folders, 3 million stock photos, and 5 workspaces. No team members on this one. But the good thing about this is that you get everything there in terms of the designer, right? So they're not limiting you of what the designer can do based on the stacking codes. So it's just if you need more workspaces or team members, then you should jump to the next ones. But one code is fine to get this. Okay, enough talk about that. Let's jump over to the dashboard. And this is how you're gonna be greeted with Pixelied, all right? So you can see some templates that you can view right here. And basically they say they have 800 plus templates right here and 20 formats. By formats, they mean like Facebook post, Facebook story, Facebook cover, and they have different sizes, right? And the way you can select variable formats is right here. So let's just go select one and jump over to the editor because that's where the important part is. In terms of designs, they look good. I feel they don't have a lot, but they look good, all right? So let me go over to YouTube, and they have three type of YouTube ones, which I haven't seen in other editors. They don't take much interest on YouTube. They jump into Twitter and Facebook and all of those. So they divide this by channel art and screen and thumbnails. So I'll go with thumbnails right here. And they're gonna show me templates that are based on thumbnails. Now, they're little crowns right here. That means if you bought the Appsumo deal, you do have access to these. So these are basic templates that you can check right here. Let me scroll all the way down, and those are all the ones that they have, okay? And if you wanna switch the format, you can select here on the left. So you can see right here, I'm on YouTube. If I select end screen, you got these available. What end screen means is that, for example, I record a video on YouTube, and at the end, YouTube gives me an opportunity to put like little thumbnails of videos. So that's why they give you these little spaces. I haven't seen these templates on other editors, but they got them here, right? Nothing fancy, but they're there. Okay, let's go back to thumbnails and just grab this one. All right, so let's grab this one. This one looks really flashy. And this is the actual editor, okay? If I click on something, the tools pop up here on the top, right? So you can see these. We have the undo, the redo, we have the resize. Now, when I resize, it will not fit everything. It's just gonna resize and it'll look all like wrong. So you have to do everything right. So it won't auto resize it. This is my personal workspace. I got access to 5 workspaces. I have the Appsumo deal. On the left, we have the type of assets that we can add. So we have templates, images, text, illustrations, mockups, elements, icons, and blends. All right, illustrations, not all the editors have, but there are many with them, okay? So what can I do with this text? For example, we could change the font. I can add my own custom font if I want. So I can add it right here or select from the ones that they have. We have obviously size, bold, italic, underlined, and strike through. We got the alignment, we got the letter spacing. So if you wanna do a little bit more spacing there, which is helpful. And also the line height spacing. In this case, it's just one line, so it won't move in anything, right? Then we have the eyedropper. So for example, if I wanna select this color, it'll change it to that color. So let's undo that, okay? But it's really useful to have an eyedropper. Next thing we have is select the color. We have the border, if we want to add that. We can add a shadow. Now, not all editors have this, but there are some that do, okay? So for example, if I add the shadow, oh, I gotta activate it, okay? There's that shadow. I like shadow because it gives it that 3D look. So for example, obviously I'll change it to white because that way it'll show, right? So it can make something stand out, and the way I'll show you that is with an icon a little bit later. Okay, so we got the opacity also, which will just make it lighter. The alignment for this, we have the alignment based on the canvas that you're working on. So for example, if I move it to the center, it's gonna do that. And then center from the center, it'll move it there. So it's pretty useful to have that. And then we have the layers. So for example, if I wanna put this behind the girl. I'll use the layers and I'll put it behind. And that's what the layers does. In my perspective, I think the layers should be a little bit more clear. I've seen other editors where you actually just drag and drop, which would be a much better way to do this, but at least you have the option to move it, all right? We have the flip. Not sure if it'll work on text. Oh yeah, it works on text, okay. And we got the lock. So for example, if I know I don't want to move this asset, I can lock it. What do I mean? Let's just say I have this behind her, right? And I want to select her or the text. For example, I want to select the text now, but I can't because I have her selected and I don't want to move that. So I could say, you know what? The girl's fine. I don't need to move her. I lock her, all right? So now I don't mess with this. So if I click on the girl, I can't select it, but I do click on the text. So the lock feature is a good feature right there. We can lock controls to like remove it, and we can delete this if we want. All right, let's do undo for that. Next thing we have are the assets, like I said before. All right, so you got access to the image library. They are provided by Unsplash, and you can select any of the ones you want right here. So for example, if I select those mountains, I'll make them a little bit bigger. Well, let's make this smaller, okay? Move the canvas there, make it like that, and I'll add the mountains right there, and I'll send it to the back. Okay, and we got some mountains right there. Okay, those are the assets that you can grab. You can search for them. For example, I always search for dogs. I like dogs. I don't have a dog, but I love dogs. Okay, and you just search for them, right? Like I said, they're provided by Unsplash. Next we have are the text. So we have your basic text based on size, and then we have text styles right here, which are really useful for selling stuff. For example, they look nice. Let me get rid of all of this just to show you really quickly. I like this. I can select them all. That's a feature I like. And we can grab something like this, okay? So it already looks fancy and I can work on that. Okay, so those are the text styles. Next thing we have are illustrations. Not all image editors have this. Some are based on just illustrations and they're really good at it. And some don't even have it, and some do and have a mix just like this, okay? So what I can do right here, let me get rid of this right here. I can add some of these illustrations. For example, I can add these and I can search for more if I want. Now, something I found was a bug is that you are supposed to be able to ungroup these and change colors individually on the illustrations that are available. But I don't know why it sometimes messes up. I should have the option right here to ungroup it and work on it. So that's maybe a bug they have, but just to let you know, you can ungroup and you can change the colors individually to your liking, depending on the brand that you're using, right? So if your brand is red, blue, and I don't know, you can change to those colors if you need to. And like I said before, there's a bug where this doesn't appear to give me the option to ungroup, okay? We got mockups. Now, mockups I think are pretty cool, but that's all they have, right? So they only have four, nothing really fancy, and what you can do with a mockup, for example, I'll add this right here, and just let me cover all of this. Okay, so this is a mockup right here, and I can add something into that space. So for example, if I go to images and I go to, I don't know, TV, it'll show me something. Well, all right, let's just say I'm watching that. Okay, so I'll just grab that and I put it in here, resize. And it doesn't give me the other size right here. But if I had the other point, I would stretch it. Or if I had my image, I would stretch it inside. And that's a mockup, right? You can put it inside of there. I hope they add way more of these because four are basically useless. It's as if they don't have any. But I will show you the roadmap in a bit to show you what they're working on, okay? Next thing we have are elements. Again, that's all the elements they have right here. And they don't have a search bar right here. So they need to add way more. Next thing we have are icons. So for example, you got a bunch of icons and they're provided by Icon Finder. Now, I asked these guys if you get the full Icon Finder library or do they get the limited version? And it looks, I asked and they said you get the 300,000 assets of icons. So that is not the complete library of them. They have 5 million assets. So might be something to consider, but they might add it or not. And if I grab an asset right here, for example, Instagram, I add that right there and I'll go to, I want to show you the drop shadow in something like this. So for example, just like that, it makes your icon look a little bit more 3D instead of just looking flat. That's what I like about shadows. And again, I can remove it if I want. Okay, you got a bunch of icons. Again, let's search for dog, which is really popular and should be easy. Okay, you got a bunch of icons right there. If I search for PC, you get all those available. Okay, the blend right here, these are blend. They consider these as, you know, they should mix together well. So you can blend stuff with this. So for example, these are based on things that are already made there. So it'll let you blend in that way. And my files, obviously, if you upload your own files, let me delete this and I uploaded that, and your files will be there. Okay, so here's my logo and that's how it shows, right? I can remove the background, I can do other stuff, I can crop it. Oh, background remover. Yeah, that's a really good feature. The background remover, I don't have an image to remove. Let me grab one from here. So let me just say person. And let's grab this one. Should be an easy one to remove the background, just for testing purposes, okay? And I'll grab this guy, I'll remove the background. Let's see if that works. Now, I saw on the roadmap that this wasn't fully integrated yet into the designer. You had to do it outside of it, and I'll show you why. But no, it works fine. Okay, here's the removed guy right here. Let me get rid of that. And there's a background remover. No limits on background removing. They're included in the deal, so nothing fancy about that. And basically, that is how the editor works, okay? Like I said before, they should be adding more, and I think other editors are ahead of this one, but if you don't have an alternative, this could be a good idea. Let me go back to the dashboard right here. Like I said before, we have the home, we have the templates, we have my designs that you worked on, we have the workspaces, so I added one for testing right here. So maybe you want to add a workspace for maybe like right now. Okay, this is a personal workspace, another space that's for your company or a different company. You have the assets there, which are based on that one. We have the background remover independent right here. So let's just say you just want to remove a background. You don't want to mess with editing anything. You have it available right here. Next thing we have are the illustrations, which are available also just to download or edit or grab them from here. So easy to have that. Next thing I want to show you is the roadmap. So this is what they have completed. This is what's in progress. So like you saw before, there's only 4 mockups. So they're actually working on that right now. So they will be adding more. And if you plan to get this deal, do jump in the we call it roadmap right now. And for example, vote on the things that you would like. So for example, mockups, I do like more. So I will vote on that. They'll add your own blend colors. So right now they only have the predefined ones, increase illustration library, expanding elements and mockup libraries. And this is what's coming later on. Now, what I found interesting right here are not these. I found this is what's coming later on. So 3D mockups. This one will be interesting because 3D mockups means that if, for example, if they add a can, or for example, I'll grab this right here. This is my bottle of water. If you add a can and you add a logo, it will wrap around it. So that is what 3D means. So if they add that, it will be really cool, but it's not implemented yet. So that's something that's coming. And these are user feedback. So right here, they're getting the feedback and they're gonna jump it over there. So basically, that is what the deal is. Like I said before, if you don't have an alternative, this could be a good deal for you. If you have an alternative that doesn't do this stuff, then yes, this is a good deal for you. But if you have several other ones like I do, then this deal is not for you. So for example, I will not be keeping this deal. I got it just for the purpose of making this video for you guys. Again, if you guys appreciate that, please use the link in my description if you would like to support me with a small commission. So basically, I just wanted to show you what's capable with Pixelied because I have many alternatives already. And this doesn't provide anything unique for me right now. Unless they add something before the deal ends, then I will jump on it again and keep it. But there you go, guys. That's the video on Pixelied. I hope you liked this video. My name's George. This is SaaS Master. And I thank you all for being here. And if you're not subscribed, please consider subscribing so you get all the latest deal updates as soon as possible and you don't miss out on them. Thank you for watching. See you guys later.